What's up, everybody? It's Mike Henderson, aka Endo. We're here at the Hub Ibiza Studios, and today we're going to be checking out the all-new TRAKTOR PRO 3.6 update, which features the all-new pattern player and iZotope Ozone Maximizer. Let's jump in the studio and check it out. TRAKTOR PRO 3.6 now features the brand new pattern player and the legendary Maximizer from iZotope's Ozone Audio Mastering Suite. Both are part of TRAKTOR's new add-on subscription model, TRAKTOR PRO Plus, which adds an ever-growing stream of exciting new features intended to improve your sound and performance. So without further ado, let's dive into this new batch of features one by one. First, we're going to learn how to use the pattern player. The pattern player is a new performance tool that allows you to add rhythmic samples on top of your tracks to bring in more variations. Innovative knob-controlled step sequencer that can be used to add drum fills and drum patterns to your DJ sets. The pattern player is located in the effects section of TRAKTOR, so it can be controlled with most TRAKTOR controllers, such as the TRAKTOR Control S4 and X1, making it plug and play into your existing setup. Note that the pattern player is only available in TRAKTOR PRO Plus. More and more professional DJs are adding drums and sounds to their DJ sets. Until now, they've used mostly TRAKTOR's remix decks or external drum machines or DAWs like Ableton Live or Machine that are synced to TRAKTOR to add drums. But this can put a strain on your CPU, and often you need to bring extra gear to your gigs. With the pattern player, everything is built into TRAKTOR, so you only need the TRAKTOR software to run it. So now you can achieve the fundamentals of what professional DJs have been doing for years using the remix decks or external gear within TRAKTOR's deck effects section. So here's how to use the pattern player. So I'm controlling the pattern player with an S4, but you can use any TRAKTOR controller with an effects section, or you can map your own MIDI controller to control the pattern player. So to get started with the pattern player, first I'm going to go to any of the effects units, and via the effects drop-down menu, I'm going to select pattern player. Now you're going to notice there's a kit display drop-down menu that allows me to choose between the different kits. So far, the only kit available is the 808 kit, but you can expect more kits in the future. You can then choose insert mode, post fader mode, or send effects mode. In post fader mode, the pattern player volume is independent of the deck volume, filter, and EQ. This lets you keep the signal from the pattern player intact during transitions. In insert mode, the pattern player sound is processed as the deck that it's applied to, allowing you to use the EQ to add even more variations with the mixer effect filters. In send mode, your pattern player can act as a fifth deck. This mode's only available in external mixing mode. So then you can use several pattern player units, creating a whole drum machine that you can then treat externally and add to the rest of your mix via a live input deck or in an external hardware mixer. Next, you're gonna need to assign the pattern player to a deck using the effects assignment buttons on any of the decks. So I'm gonna assign the pattern player, which is effects unit 1, to deck B. So it's now on its own channel of my S4. So you can give the pattern player its own channel, or you can combine it into the same channel as a deck. And the sound is gonna come through whatever channel that effects unit's assigned to. Now the pattern player is gonna follow the master deck or the master clock. So first I'm gonna play a track. And then next I'm gonna start the playback of the pattern player. Now to start the pattern player, I can use the play stop button. And the play stop button is gonna be quantized, so it's gonna wait for the next beat of the track and it's gonna start playback right on the beat to allow for more intuitive syncing. Now you can hear the snare drum coming in over the track. Now I can use the volume knob to control the volume of the pattern that's playing. Now I can select the sound I want using the next and previous buttons, either on my controller or in the software. So you can see right now we have a snare, but we also have a clap, closed hi-hat, open hi-hat, shaker, ride, kick, clave. So this is the default 808 kit. So each sample has its own pattern bank that's thought to be as musical as possible. So when I change the sample, you probably notice that the pattern player changes in the pattern visualizer. So this will help you visualize the pattern that you're playing and also help you memorize the pattern. So the second knob, which is the pattern selection knob, is going to control the intensity of the pattern for faster drum rolls, for example. So as you turn the knob clockwise, the patterns get denser to give you the most intuitive feeling. All right, now on the third knob, you have the pitch. So turning this knob will control the pitch of your sample, and this is going to go up or down by 12 semitones. All right, and then the last knob controls the decay of the sample. So as I turn the knob clockwise, the release of the sample is longer. All right, so now let's talk about ducking. So let's say I want to combine the pattern player with the same channel as a deck. I can do this using the ducking function. So ducking sidechains the affected track to the pattern player sample, which is useful if you want to push the pattern player sound forward. So the amount of sidechain is modulated by the sample volume, and then its decay is modulated by the sample decay. Let's check out how it works. So I have a track playing. I'm going to assign the pattern player to the same deck that I'm playing, the same channel. I'm going to play a kick drum sample. Now let's hear how that kick drum sounds with ducking. You can hear how it cuts through the mix a little better. So one of my favorite things to do with the pattern player is to actually chain it with additional effects. So I could add things like delays and reverbs to any of the drums that I'm bringing into the mix, just giving me all kinds of new performance possibilities. So let's check out how that works. So right now I have deck B set to the pattern player and effects unit 2. Let's add a clave sound. So I have a reverb and a delay on effect unit 2. All right, so now let's talk about the Ozone Maximizer in TRAKTOR. The Ozone Maximizer is like a limiter, but it's better and more intelligent. It's meant to protect your audio from clipping or distorting, and can also be used as a tool to boost the overall loudness of your sets and your recordings, so you can stand out in a crowd while preserving the transients, the dynamics, and the magic of your songs. In technical terms, the Ozone Maximizer allows more transparent limiting with less pumping at higher volumes. The Ozone Maximizer algorithm is an intelligent limiter that adjusts the release time to the input signal with the goal of preserving transients, but at the same time minimizing the distortion. The Ozone Maximizer will prevent your master from clipping while dramatically lifting the perceived overall audio levels for more loudness, all without sacrificing the crisp detail of your tracks. So to use the maximizer on your master output, you need to first enable the limiter usage in the mixing mode you're using. So I'm going to go to Preferences, Output Routing, and then I'm going to select the mixing mode that I want to use. Since I'm using an S4, I'm selecting Internal Mixing Mode. Then I'm going to go to Preferences, Mixer, and in that tab, I'm either in Internal or External Mixing Mode, I'm going to select the limiter type as Ozone. So now you can use the Ozone Maximizer tab in the preferences here to configure the settings of the maximizer. The threshold level sets the signal level at which the limiter starts limiting and thereby affecting the audio signal. Preset allows you to choose between two different characters of the maximizer. Fast is going to use faster attack and release settings to catch signal spikes quicker, while the smooth algorithm uses slower attack and decay settings to preserve the transients. You can test both of them out to find which one suits the best to your ears and to the music that you're playing. And then gain reduction shows how many dB of gain are being reduced based on the threshold value. We recommend keeping the gain reduction below 6 dB to avoid experiencing any audio distortion. All right, so now I'm gonna demo the Ozone Maximizer and show you how it works. And I'm gonna crank the gains a little bit so that I start hitting the limiter. You can actually see in the master panel here, as soon as I start hitting the limiter, the levels start hitting this line. So now I'm gonna use the threshold here. Check out, as I lower the threshold, you can actually see the gain reduction in the master panel. Something that's been there for a while, but maybe you didn't notice. And in the preferences panel, I can also see the gain reduction. And that's the Pattern Player in Maximizer in TRAKTOR PRO 3.6. I hope you all have fun with these new features. Happy mixing, everybody. Peace.